Would you like to find out about the shocking discovery that links cannabis with omega-3 fatty acids? Good, because in this video, you'll learn about the bad cannabis and you'll learn about the good cannabis and how the good cannabis in the form of CBD oil could supplement the positive effects of omega-3 fatty acids. So, whilst we're on the high, I'll pass you over to Harry Boy, who will let you in on all the juicy secrets. Over to you, Harry.
Smoking cannabis or weed or marijuana or whatever you want to call it is basically illegal, although there are places around the world that allow it, either on a socially acceptable basis or on a quasi-legal footing. However, for anyone who respects their health and body, why would anyone in their right mind want to smoke a drug to get as high as a kite, especially when there are better, safer and legal ways to put yourself in a good and happy mood? Meanwhile, getting an ongoing collection of news, reports, resources and courses on various health and wellness issues linked or connected with omega-3 is so easy to access. Just take a quick moment to subscribe and click the bell icon so you'll never miss out on future videos uploaded to this channel again. Plus, watch this video to the very end to gain access to a special invitation. Firstly, cannabis or marijuana comes from the family of cannabis plants, and there are two parts, the bad part and the good part. The bad part is the one that gets all the negative publicity, where everyone knows cannabis as being an intoxicating and illegal drug that's usually smoked as a joint and gets people stoned. This is the tetrahydrocannabinol, THC, part of a cannabis plant. The good part of the plant is known as cannabidiol, CBD, and this is what this video will be focusing on, although it's worth mentioning that tests continue to be carried out on THC, as this has anti-inflammatory attributes that could be harnessed for eventual medical purposes. Secondly, there are two key factors to bear in mind about cannabis. Your body has a neurotransmitter system called ECS, the endocannabinoid system, which controls various functions of your body, such as 1. Pain and stress. 2. Memory and mood. 3. Inflammation. 4. Muscle stability and recovery, and 5. Hunger, sleep and energy. The endocannabinoids are naturally produced by your body and help activate the ECS. And to keep the ECS functioning efficiently, your body needs omega-3 fatty acids. If you have a deficiency of omega-3 fatty acids, and 95% of the world is estimated to be woefully deficient, then the ECS doesn't function as it should, and so the breakdown in the system becomes apparent by the onset of chronic illnesses and degenerative diseases. However, we now know that the cannabis plant family produces cannabidiol, CBD, which also activates the ECS. So, a lack of omega-3 fatty acids in your body will, over a period of time, lead to things like 1. Abnormally high levels of inflammation. 2. Serious mood disorders, and 3. Sleeping problems. And all of these will help lower your body's natural defenses, your immune system. The ECS is reliant on omega-3 fatty acids, and without them, the ECS cannot function efficiently. In addition, the ECS generates its own endocannabinoids from these and other fatty acids, thereby confirming the essential nature of omega-3s. Omega-3 fatty acids are anti-inflammatory, and when you eat foods that contain omega-3 fatty acids, your body converts them into endocannabinoids, the body-produced version of cannabinoids. It follows then that cannabinoids help keep inflammation in check and under control. So, when it comes to getting your high, eat the following omega-3-rich foods, such as 1. Wild salmon, mackerel and herring. 2. Walnuts. 3. Chia seeds and flaxseeds. 4. Spinach, Brussels sprouts and kale. That way, you can start to fix your likely omega-6 to omega-3 imbalance in your body. But will it be enough? Probably not, so you'll likely have to top up with omega-3 supplements, but even then, it's likely you won't redress the omega-6 to omega-3 imbalance. And whilst the focus is on providing your body with more omega-3 fatty acids, don't forget that it's just as easy to reduce your omega-6 fatty acids intake by simply reducing, and eventually cutting out, all of the processed foods you eat, such as 1. Takeaway foods, including burgers, fish and chips etc. 2. Microwave meals. 3. Pies and processed meats. 4. Vegetable cooking oils. 5. Desserts and ice creams, and 6. Sweets and chocolate. Even taking these steps, how do you know what your omega-6 to omega-3 balance is? Today, the good part of the cannabis plant family, the CBD, can be manufactured into CBD oil and is readily available for sale on the internet. However, even CBD oil is splitting opinion as to its effectiveness and safety amongst interested parties. And here's the confusion surrounding CBD oil. CBD oil is manufactured from the leaves and flowers of the hemp plant, with the hemp plant being referred to as non-intoxicating cannabis harvested for the industrial use of its derived products, which includes textiles, body care products and building materials, and much more. Whilst hemp is a term used in association with cannabis plants, it was recognized as being legal in the Agricultural Act 2018 in the US. In other words, it doesn't allow people to get as high as a kite. So, with that confusing issue cleared up, here are the main points on how CBD works alongside omega-3 fatty acids. 1. It affects the cell metabolism in the endocannabinoid system, ECS, which regulates your mood, your immune system, and how your body responds to damage incurred, such as cuts and knocks. 2. The endocannabinoids in the cells are made by the omega-3 and omega-6 fatty acids, which stimulate the cell receptors. 3. These endocannabinoids and receptors perform many functions and have a beneficial impact upon chronic illnesses and degenerative diseases, and 4. Both CBD and omega-3 fatty acids are virtually dependent on one another to help maintain body and brain functionality, and for maintaining the upkeep of your immune system. However, there are a number of issues to be aware of. 1. CBD oil is not a substitute for a deficiency in omega-3 fatty acids. 2. Many people view and use CBD oil as a quick, short-term fix to relieve pain and discomfort, and mood swings and depression, whereas getting your omega-6 to omega-3 balance is a long-term issue that's sustainable via your diet, and quality supplements that you consume. 3. The world's population is reckoned to be 95% out of balance, in terms of omega-6 to omega-3, so anyone thinking they can use CBD oil as a deficiency replacement are missing the point. And, 4. The FDA, the US Food and Drug Administration, do not allow the combining of omega-3 supplements with CBD oil. Summing up, then. 1. Smoking cannabis is illegal, although there are a number of exceptions in certain parts of the world. 2. Elements of the cannabis plant family, such as hemp, which is used in the manufacture of CBD oil, can help stimulate and support the benefits that omega-3 fatty acids provide the body, but more in a short-term facility, rather than as an ongoing long-term requirement. 3. It's just as important to reduce your omega-6 intake of processed and sugar-rich foods, as it is to change your diet to include omega-3-rich foods. 4. CBD oil is not a substitute for omega-3 fatty acids, and 5. Do you know what your omega-6 to omega-3 balance ratio is? If you'd like to learn more about getting the right balance of fatty acids in your body to achieve optimal health, complete and submit the special invitation URL link in the description box below this video. Then, if you like the content of this and other videos on the Omega 3 Zone channel, and maintaining or improving your health and fitness is a priority in your life, then please feel free to share this video with like-minded people. In which case, by subscribing to the Omega 3 Zone channel, please click the subscribe button at the bottom of this video, and then by clicking the bell icon, this will ensure that you get notified of future videos being uploaded. And now, before you can access those further videos, here's the boring, but essential bit. Kindly note, the content of this video does not constitute medical advice in any shape or form, and has been created for passive informational purposes only. End of boring, but essential bit. And now all that's left is to remind you about the special invitation, in the description box below this video.